Good morning, everybody. Back in the 1970s, Carole King wrote a song which was a big hit. She recorded it, and James Taylor then recorded the song. They also did versions together, and James Taylor had a really big hit with this song. It was extremely popular, and I used to play this song, you know, before I got saved. And then in 1978, when I came to Christ, and I was, you know, a musician, and I realized that the words to the song just didn't really sit exactly right as far as being a Christian, because one of the lines in the song says, winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you got to do is call, and I'll be there, and you've got a friend. And I realized that, you know, no human friend can fully fulfill that in another person's life. You know, there's just times when even your best friend just can't be there, and you can't be there for them, or maybe they died, or so they can't always be there when you call. I mean, a lot of times you find yourself feeling alone, and anyway, I realized that for me to sing that song, and I needed to change a couple of words, so I hope you'll bear with me as I, if you know the song, I've changed a couple of the words, so it's called You Got a Friend. When you're down and troubled and you need some love and care, Nothing is going right. Close your eyes and think of him. Soon he will be there to brighten up even your darkest night. You just call out his name, and you know he's always the same. He will be there to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you got to do is call. He'll be there, yes he will. You've got a friend. If the sky above you should turn dark and full of clouds, and that old north wind should begin to blow, keep your head together. Call his name out loud. Soon he'll be knocking upon your door. You just call out his name. No, he's always the same. He will be there to see you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you got to do is call. He'll be there, yes he will. Hey now, ain't it good to know you've got a friend? People can be so cold. They'll hurt you, yes, and desert you. Well, they'll take your soul if you let them. Oh, but don't you let them. You just call out his name. You know he's always the same. He will be there you again. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you got to do is call. He'll be there, yes he will. You got a friend. Amen. The Bible says, a man that hath friends must show himself friendly. And it says, there is a friend who sticks closer than a brother. And I know that that's Jesus Christ. So whenever you feel alone, you're not alone. I have a verse that I came across a couple of days ago, way back in Deuteronomy chapter 33 and verse 12. And Moses, in this chapter, was pronouncing blessings upon the 12 tribes of Israel just before Moses died. These were kind of like his final words to his beloved people Israel. And God gave him blessings for each one of those tribes. And when he got to Benjamin, the tribe of Benjamin, he said this in Deuteronomy 33, verse 12. And of Benjamin, he said, the beloved of the Lord shall dwell in safety by him. And the Lord shall cover him all the day long, and he shall dwell between his shoulders. There's a beautiful intimacy in this verse. I'd like to read it again for you. And picture yourself in this verse, because you are loved by God. It's addressed to the beloved. And the Bible says God so loved the world, and that's you and me. He loves us with an everlasting love. And he sent his only son to be our savior. So listen to this again and picture yourself in this verse. The beloved of the Lord shall dwell in safety by him. And the Lord shall cover him all the day long, and he shall dwell between his shoulders. There's a real beautiful intimacy there with the Lord that we can have every day. You know, the Bible says, in all thy ways acknowledge him and he'll direct your path. We should always treat the Lord like he's there. All the time, no matter what we're doing, if we're on a call or just going somewhere, wherever we are, always treat the Lord like he's really there and acknowledge him. I used to go into Lowe's, you know, the building supply place, Lowe's, pretty much every day when I used to do carpenter work full time. And sometimes I remember, you know, just greeting somebody that I knew, maybe another construction guy, and maybe his name was Joe, and I'd say, hey, Joe, how you doing? And once in a while, you'd hear this answer. You'd say, well, doesn't do any good to complain because nobody's listening anyway. And you've heard that said, and sometimes I've even heard Christians answer that. They say, well, doesn't do any good to complain. Nobody's listening anyway. But the reality is somebody is always listening. Somebody's always there. One of my favorite names of the Lord, and God has many, many names in the Bible that describe him, but one of my favorites is Emmanuel, which means God with us. Not God somewhere else, or just God with some other people, or the man way upstairs, some kind of distant, cold deity. No, it says Emmanuel means God with us. 1 Corinthians 3:16 says, do you not know that you are the temple of the Holy Spirit, and that the Spirit of God dwells in you? Colossians 1:27 says, Christ in you, the hope of glory. So I pray today, as a result of this little video clip, that you'll remember that you do have a friend. You've got a friend all the time, everywhere you go. And he can handle whatever is going on with you and whatever is going on with the world. Don't forget, see that little light up there above the clouds? The light is always shining. Jesus is on the throne, and you've got a friend in Jesus.